I don't give a damn. I don't care if you gotta sell everything you got.
What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business, asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on, show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here. You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Me 10 seconds ago.
For crying out loud.
What the hell's the matter with you now?
It's taking you forever, and I'm cold.
So sit in the damn car if you're cold.
Can I help you with something?
It's cold in the car, too. Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
It'd get done a hell of a lot quicker if you quit nagging me and give me a hand.
I am not nagging you.
Yeah, uh-huh. Well, if you're as good with a wrench as you were with your mount, we could have this damn thing fixed already.
You are so useless. It's no wonder the army wouldn't take you.
You had to bring that up again, didn't you?
Ethel's husband, Frank, he's a fighter pilot. Margaret's husband, Charlie, he drives a submarine.
I'm warning you.
My husband? Oh, he's a 4F. He works at the grocery store.
You know what? Fix it yourself then, you lousy bitch!
Hey, need a hand?
Sure do. Hope you're better at this thing than my good-for-nothing husband.
There we go. All done. I just needed to, screw a couple things in.
Really? Well, thank you very much, handsome.
Don't mention it. Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live. Disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. We need to stop and we can all have fun.
The fun's over, baby. Later, I said. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. Now, you know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set. Because you know me.
So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy, Giuseppe. Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, Never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right, here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
Been hoping that you'd drop in.
So very nice.
I'll hold your hand.
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. Slow it down a bit. No need to get... Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
Say, what's in the street?
You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it.
Mind if I move in closer?
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride? Really? Maybe don't hold out.
Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's.